Hello everyone, many of you asked me, please make a video, please tell me how much you earn as a PhD, can we survive a PhD with the PhD salary with a family, can we survive as an individual, how much amount can I save to pay back my loans. So in this video, I will go through my payslip and show you exactly how much I earned and how much you can earn in a PhD. And in the last part of the video, I'll also show you how much I earned in my YouTube. So this entire video is about how much money I earn in a month while doing my PhD and also doing these YouTube videos, where the main purpose is to help you out. People who are watching me know that I started my PhD in September 2017. So now I'm showing you the payslip of September 2020. Which is the final year of my PhD, and the one that you see salaries. This payslip is in Dutch, so I will try to explain specific important points which you need to know to understand the salary. So salaries means the gross salary, and in the gross salary you can see it is 3061 euros for September 2020, which is the final year PhD salary, where you are in the P3 scale. So it starts from P0 and it goes to P3, P0, P1, P2, P3 in the 4 years of your PhD, which is the ideal time that you should complete your PhD. And then there are additions and deductions depending on how much allowance you get, like internet allowance, or maybe a vacation allowance, or maybe some bonus which you get at the end of the PhD, which is kind of like a 13th month bonus. The vacation allowance that you see, that is also kind of paid at the end of the year, but I asked them to pay it to me every month. So ideally, you work for 12 months, but you get salary for 14 months. So these two extra months, one is the vacation allowance and one is the end year allowance. Vacation allowance, you can take them every month instead of getting it at the end of the year, but the bonus that you get at the end of the year, that is the end year or 13th month allowance. That allowance is basically approximately 8%, which is approximately like 1 month salary. But the thing is that your normal salary is taxable between 30 to 40%. It also depends how much is your gross. But your end salary, like the bonus, is always taxable at a higher rate, something around 50%. So if you take it on a net salary basis, if you see my September 2020 payslip, in the net salary I earn like around 2453.46 euros. And you can see the allowances in the top, like the internet allowance, travel allowance, that's the rice cost and the tax deductions and everything. One thing, don't confuse, you might be confused while seeing this. Here in Netherlands, your comma means full stop, and full stop means comma when you write numbers. So don't get confused for that. Decimal value is comma and comma is decimal. They are like reverse as you write in normal English. Mathematical numbers. That is very confusing initially. Even people who are applying for universities have this confusion. So basically, if you see on the net salary basis, then the 2 months extra bonus is actually after tax deduction. It is kind of 1 month extra net salary. So apart from these net salaries that you see, you get one or half a month of net salary extra at the end of the year. So to give that example, you can see end of the year of 2019 payslip, where I have like 13th month salary. That is the bonus that I was talking about. So after taxes, if you combine, then you can see how much I get as a net salary of the 13th month. So you can see in 2019, in the bonus month, that is the month of December, I got like 3867 euros. While in a normal month in 2019, I got around 2279 euros. So you can make the comparison, like a normal month of 2020 is 2453 something and it is 2279. So there you see the difference. So in the gross also, you can see that my gross salary in 2019 was around 2835 euros. So, and my net was 2279 after the allowance and deductions. So the gross salary always, so the tax is very high. So even though your gross salary difference between the years is maybe like 200 euros, but the net difference will be very less. because the higher the gross becomes, the more you pay as a tax. So the gross salary is this, and in 2018, in a normal month, my net salary was 2134 euro. My gross salary was 2640 euro. So you see, like, from second year to third year PhD, you get a small increment in the gross salary, and the third year to final year, you again get a small increment. But if you see the first year, then you'll be surprised, it is very low. So in the first year, my gross was 2222, four twos, and then my net was 1879 euros. So after the first year, you have a first year review meeting, and in that, if you pass, then they extend your contract for 3 more years. And then the hike of the gross salary from first year to second year is really huge, as you can see. But from the second to third and third to fourth, it is very small hikes. You get small hikes. So, and also this salary changes every year according to the labor agreement and everything. So if you come now, or if you come in the future when you're watching this video, because I'm making this video in 2020 December, then you will get higher salary. So that there is a pay scale. You can see in the first year you get P0, then P1, P2, P3. And similarly, and also one more thing, you might get higher salary even after that by paying less taxes if you have a 30% ruling. And ideally, most of the time, if you are coming from abroad as an expat to do PhD directly in Netherlands and you have not studied here, then you will definitely get a 30% ruling. So same person like me joining at the same time, if I have studied here, will get a less salary, something minor difference in the net salary, because of the 30% benefit you get. You can Google it, 30% benefit, and I have a playlist of what taxes and allowances you can get in Netherlands. Check it out, you will know everything about it. Yeah, so this is my entire story of my PhD earnings. You can get an estimate of how much I earn in the somewhere in future. If you like it, then I'll make a video about how much I save in Netherlands. Okay, so I hope you like the transparency. So now I'll talk about my YouTube earnings, which is a very short story. It will be like less than a minute, I guess. So the YouTube earnings vary a lot, and I never decided or made any planning of earning from YouTube, because I had at least some monetary benefit from my PhD, which is not bad. Like what PhD graduates get all over the world. So that's why I thought, like, just help out people. That's why I made the YouTube videos. So you can see on the screen, it varies between 15 to 30 euros each month. So my channel was first monetized in August 2019, and then it was earning some money over each month. During the pandemic, the ad rates dipped, really dipped. So it was around 15, and another reason, maybe during the pandemic, I also made very less videos. Normally I put like one or two videos a week. At that time, I think I put only 3 or 4 videos a month instead of 8. So that may be a reason. And it is also, I read that the ad rates were low during the pandemic. So yeah, so you can see I'm moving through different months of my earnings from the YouTube. Yeah, so if you want to make YouTube as a business, because if you go into my expenses, that is another story. It's completely negative if you go into like what gain I have made from YouTube. So that was never my plan. It was just a passion and my desire to help you out, spread the information. So I hope you like this video. You learned how much I earn in a month from a PhD, and how much money I earn, and also from the YouTube. So don't forget to smash the like button, help each other out, share this video, share the information so that more people can join. And if you have any questions, put them in the comments. I will definitely answer them. And if you want to make this as a career choice, like do a PhD or YouTube, then you have an idea. And definitely you will get more, at least in the PhD, because salary increases every year, depending on the expenses. So don't forget to subscribe to the channel. See you in upcoming videos. Till then, goodbye from Netherlands. Peace.